Aloha. Here at ThinkTech Hawaii, we have had several long-running shows about the current state of politics. CEO and founder Jay Fidel asked hosts to answer the question, since January 6th, what have we learned? I'm Cynthia Sinclair, a ThinkTech host. Here are some of my answers to that question. We have learned that a large majority of Republicans think that violence has become an acceptable way to get what you want. Hate, racism, and lies have become the norm for a large, vocal, violent swath of our country. We have learned that the word patriot has been twisted through misinformation to mean something new and dangerous. We have learned that the big lie that has been propagated by the Republican Party is still being pushed on anyone who will listen, sowing doubt and undermining people's trust in our elections, leading to new state laws that remove nonpartisan election officials and gives power to partisan politicians. We have learned that right-wing media has become a dangerous threat that is undermining democracy, eroding the fabric of truth, and destroying established norms. They are the biggest purveyor of the big lie and other machinations of disinformation. They are actively working to divide and polarize our nation. We have learned that accountability is the missing piece that has put our democracy in danger. Some 700 insurrectionists have been arrested, but only a handful have been charged. Most were given light sentences. The lack of severe penalties has given the appearance that what happened wasn't so bad, something the right-wing media has used to foster extremism and promote the big lie. We have learned that behind the scenes, the January 6th committee has interviewed over 300 people connected with the attack on the Capitol. They have received thousands of documents, phone logs, and text messages. Last weekend, we were told that the committee now has firsthand accounts that the former president was watching the insurrection from his private dining room at the White House. He was being urged by many people to speak out and tell the rioters to stop. He refused. And what's more, during the speech Trump gave at the Ellipse on the 6th, he told the people in attendance that Mike Pence could still come through for them. When the insurrection was in full swing, Trump tweeted that Mike Pence was not going to come through for them. After he tweeted that, the rioters began to chant, "Hang Mike Pence." We have learned that we are at great risk for losing our democracy to autocratic rule. We are officially listed as a democracy in decline. And finally, we have learned that we must be intentional, ready to stand strong against this onslaught of misinformation and lies. We must all stand up, unafraid, and speak truth to power before it's too late.